Very good morning to all of you. Now, as we have finished our last chapter, that is chapter 7, congruency of triangles. Now we will start from chapter 8, that is comparing quantities. In this, first we read some basic definitions or the basic concepts which related to exercise 8.1 and which is helpful in solving the problems in exercise 8.1. So the first concept is of ratio. What is ratio? So ratio is the ratio of two quantities is ratio of two quantities of the same kind of the same kind and in the same units is a fraction that shows how many times the one quantity is of the other. The one quantity of the other. Thus the ratio of two quantities A and B. Suppose the two quantities are A and B, where B is not equal to zero, is A divided by B, or A by B is denoted by A is to B. A is to B. Okay? And in the ratio, A is to B, the quantities A and B are called the terms of the ratio. A and B
are called the terms of the ratio.
The
here in the ratio first term that is called
antecedent
and the last or the second term that is B is called
constituent.
So here is the concept of ratio.
So here is the concept of ratio. You can all note it down.
Now
our
next concept is ratio in the simplest form. Ratio in the simplest form.
Ratio in the simplest form.
A ratio A is to B is said to be
in the simplest form. Antecedent A and consequent B have
no common factor. Other than 1. And a ratio which is in the simplest form is also called in its lowest term.
You can now note it down.
Now next topic.
Our next topic is
equivalent ratios. Equivalent ratios. A ratio obtained by multiplying
and
dividing the antecedent and the consequent of the ratio with the same number is called
equivalent ratio. For example,
suppose find equivalent ratio of ratio 6:4.
Okay. So,
for this, what we have the ratio that is 6:4. Here, antecedent of this ratio is the first term.
As we know that the first term is called the antecedent of the ratio. So, antecedent is 6 and the last term or the second term is called the consequent, which is equal to 4. Okay. So the equivalent ratio can be written as 6/4,
and when we multiply 6/4 with 2, if it is written
in the fraction form or in rational number form, then the first term become now numerator and the last term become now denominator.
So when the first term is multiplied by 2, then 4 is also multiplied by 2. What will we get? 12 and 8.
This is the first equivalent ratio of 6:4. Then
for the next 6/4,
when it multiplied by the next integer, that is
3, and here also 3. Always remember that
you have to multiply with the same number in denominator and numerator, or you have to divide. If you are dividing the ratio, then you have to divide with the same number in the antecedent and in the consequent. That is, when you write and it in ratio in fractional form, then antecedent become numerator and consequent become denominator. Then if you divide or multiply the numerator with any number, then you have to divide or multiply the denominator of that number with same number.
So 6 into 3, that is 18, 4 into 3, that is 12. So our next is 6 by 4 into 4 and into 4, 24 upon 16. 24 upon 16.
Okay, so here
we can find many more. We can find many more values
like this. Okay.
Now also we can write it as, if you are if you want to find equivalent ratio by dividing this number, you can also find. If you divide 6 by 2, then you have to divide 4 by 2 also. So you will get 3 by 2.
Okay? So the equivalent ratios are
of 6 to 4. The equivalent ratios of 6 is to 4 as first thing. 12 is to 8, 18 is to 12, 24 is to 16, 3 is to 2, and so on.
And so on. So you all can note it down now. Now you all can note it down.
Now make a note in that topic, in equivalent ratio. The note is that if A is to B and C is to D,
if A is to B and C is to D are two equivalent ratios,
are two equivalent ratios,
then
we write it as A upon B is equals to C upon D.
Note it now.
Okay.
Now, the next concept is
proportion. Proportion.
Equality of two ratios.
Equality of two ratios is called,
equality of two ratios is called
a proportion, a called the proportion. Suppose, for an example, the two ratios are consider the two ratios. First one is 6 is to 18, and 6 is to 18, and the other is 8 is to 24. Now we find that 6 is to 18 can be written as 1 is to 3, or 6 is what the lowest form, the simplest form, or the lowest form of ratio 6 is to 18 is 1 is to 3. Okay? So 1 is to 3. And what is the simplest form of 8 is to 24? It is also 1 is to 3. So here we find two equal ratios, 1 is to 3 and 1 is to 3. So therefore 6 is to 18 is equal to 8 is to 24. They are equal. Just like that, 6 is to 18 is equal to 8 is to 24 is the proportion. Okay. So in general, four numbers like A, B, C and D, A, B, C and D are said to be in proportion, are said to be in proportion if the ratio of the first two is equal to the ratio of the last two. If the ratio of first two is equal to the is equal to the ratio of the last two. Okay? That is, A is to B is equals to C is to D. If the numbers A, B, C and D are in the proportion, then we write it as, then we write A is to B, C is to D. So here, this is read as A is to B as C is to D. A is to B as C is to D. It means that A is related to D, C is related to D as the same manner as A is related to B, or the ratio of A is to B is equals to the ratio of C is to D. The ratio of A is to B as equals to ratio of C is to D. Okay? Here, in this, there are four terms you can see here: A, B, C, D. First, second, third, and fourth. Here, the first and fourth terms of a proportion are called extremes and the second and third terms are called the middle terms or means. And the second and the third terms are called middle terms or means. Here A and B are first and fourth term, that is called extremes, and C, B and C are second and respectively B and C are second and third term, which is called means of the proportion here. Okay, so you all can note it down. For example, we have the ratio. Suppose we have the ratio 40 is to 700 as 40 is to 70 as 200 is to 350. Okay, so here we check product of extreme and product of middle term or mean of this ratio. So product of extreme is product of extreme. For this product of extreme is 40 into 350. We will get 14,000 and product of mean that is 70 into 200, then we will get 14,000. This is like that. Product of x mean dollar equals to product of mean. Product of mean. Okay, now you all can note it down. Now we will discuss the first example of your exercise. Exercise 8.1. First example. Example first.
That in that we have to, in that we have to find the ratio. Find the ratio of 3 km to 300 m.
Find the ratio of 3 km to 300 m.
Okay. First the number should be converted in the same ratio. So
we know that 1 km is equals to 1000 m. Hence, therefore, 3 km is equals to 3000 m.
Okay. Now the numbers converted in the same ratio.
So the required ratio is 3000 is to 300. Here we get 10 is to 1. 10 is to 1.
Okay. So now you all can note it down.
Okay. Now note down your homework. Your homework is learn and write.
Only learn
all the definitions. Learn all the definitions and do question number 1 of exercise 8.1.
Thank you, Kunal. Thank you, class. It's all over for today. Thank you.